Hey, what's going on YouTube? Today I'm going to talk about something unfortunate, also good, and stuff in between. Okay, so one's going to have to do with an eBay purchase I made that maybe some other people have run into, but this is my first time and I wasn't sure exactly how to handle it. But I was a little upset at what happened, and I let the seller know that I was upset. So I'll talk about that in a second. Also talk about something good that happened. That happened with a pack of Prism that was really cool. That's a fun story. I just wanted to touch on that. And also, if you see like all these cards, I got stacks of cards everywhere. Stacks of cards, stacks of cards. I honestly have had a blast going through my old, you know, collection just to for this giveaway for you guys. I've gone through and I've found some gems, I think. The hardest person, I have to say that, because I had a pretty good idea of where everybody was Kevin, because he's a Nationals fan. And the reason why that I had so much trouble with Kevin is because when I was collecting, there wasn't a Washington Nationals. They didn't exist. They were the Expos, you know? So, I went and I tried to find some Expos cards, which obviously I had some Expos cards, so I put some of those in there, and I do have one card for him that I think is really, really, really special. I think that he's going to love, but I have to say by far he was probably the most difficult, but as you can see, I've got tons and tons of cards for people I just thought of in the community. I know that they collect, and I just started pulling them out, and this is on top of the packages that I've already made for everybody. But as you can see, what you're going to get is something similar to this. It says, I had 20 cards, but I probably went overboard on quite a few of these. So this one right here, I think is for Corey. It said 20-ish cards, so you'll probably see that, or maybe even more, just so that you know, I'm pretty much got most of them finished, and I've already got I've already paid for all of the shipping stuff, and I've got the labels and stuff printed out. My plan is to ship those probably tomorrow. Today's Thursday, so everything will probably go out tomorrow. As I got another thing I need to ship, which I'll show that real quick if I can find it right here. I actually ended up selling my Jerry Jeudy 2/10. I sold this for 100, I want to say, or maybe just over 100. I was surprised that this got a lot of watchers, but nobody actually wanted to pay for it. I had started with like over 200. And then I saw one end up only selling for like 70 in an auction style. Not that I'm not a big believer in him. I just, you know, I'm not a Broncos fan for one. So I thought somebody else would probably enjoy the card a little bit more. Plus, it's not in their Broncos uniform yet, or their professional uniform. So, yeah, I don't know. This didn't mean as much to me as it could mean to somebody else, so I put it up for auction. And that person hopefully is a Broncos fan, but maybe they're just a flipper because it looked like a power seller. Now, on the flip side of that, I made that purchase. And when I made that purchase, I also decided to make a buy last week for an MPJ. If you guys don't know, in basketball, he's been tearing it up. Now, everything about this, the way it is packed, you know, I was like, wow, this is really great. It's packed really well. He had it taped inside of here. It's awesome. And when I first look at the card, I'm like, what is going on here? So if you look at this card, the first thing immediately is that it's crazy off-center, top to bottom, and left to right. You see that? Right there, and then this is almost off-cut. Like, it looks like it's about to miss the top of the card. And I just was like, what the heck? On the picture that it was shown, and I paid $50 for this card, or $49 or something like that for this card. Buy it now. Because this is before he had his back-to-back 30-point games. He's just rising. So I was like, you know, I don't think I have one, so I'll pick it up. And it's even off-center on the back. It's just, but the picture had almost like a perfect, I was like, man, that looks like a 9 or a 10 on the picture. And I get this one, and I don't even think it'll be an 8. So let me show you real quick. I sort of, I wasn't sure how to handle this. I was upset when I got the card, so I just sent him a message like, hey, man, this is a really, you know, crappy thing to do, but I didn't use that word. I said at the time that I wasn't going to take any action. I just wanted him to know that I knew that he sent me the wrong card. And I think, you know, obviously, maybe he didn't do it on purpose, but it really felt like, you know, it was on purpose because he shows this really perfect card and then he sends me this. So I want to show you the card real quick, and then you guys tell me what you think. Let's see, if I go back. Let me look at my purchase history real fast. On the other side note, you're going to see this in my purchase history. I decided to go ahead and, here it is. Decided to go ahead and buy all the heroes. Okay, so I don't know if you guys can see this. Let me zoom in. Look at that picture. This card looks perfect. Look at the top right here. Oops. See how there's only three lines there, and it looks like everything looks perfect, and there's a lot of top to bottom. The sides on the left, look at this left side here. Looks perfect. You got three dots instead of two. I mean, the card looks awesome. I'm like, holy crap, that looks like a perfect, you know, version. And it even says in the title that this is a Michael Porter Jr. rookie, a great shape, clean. And, I mean, card was packed, pulled, put immediately into a penny sleeve, top loader, and team bag. Listing is for the item shown in the photo. It says that specifically right here. And then I get this card. Might not be able to do this because I got two lights going on here. Let me just move this back out of the way. I don't know how you guys would handle this. I told him that I wasn't going to take action because I just knew now everything looks sort of yellow. I'm going to have to get better lighting. Let me go back. There we go. All right. See, like, look at the difference. This has got four lines almost off the top. Here you only got... You get three dots, but it's like off. The third dot is like in this next line. It's weird. I don't know. I'm not sure what to do. I guess I could send it back. But I already told him I wasn't going to take action. I was just upset, and I thought that it was morally wrong for him to do what he did. And he hasn't responded, so I don't know. I mean, obviously he knows that he probably did wrong. But maybe he just made a mistake. So I was like, maybe leaving it up for him to make it right, but he hasn't said anything yet, so we'll see. Anyways, on a lighter note, I don't want to, like, bring down the mood and everybody be like, well, you know, that's just selling, whatever. So, okay, so here's an example. I made, you know, I buy into breaks occasionally, obviously, and one that I like to buy in is Card Collector 2, which you guys probably know. He's pretty good. Big name in the... in this field, you know, he's got his own hobby shop down in Columbus. I'm an Ohio guy, so I like to support him, and I do some of his breaks. One thing that happens in his particular breaks is that if you get the Utah Jazz or the Houston Rockets sometimes in his big mixers, he'll throw in a prism pack. So here's an example where I have the Utah Jazz, and I just so happen to get this really nice Donovan Mitchell Red Wave prism, and I did get this, a Genesis Joe Ingles, but I also got a prism pack, and then I got, you know, these just some basic, like, Joe Ingles mosaic cards or whatever. So you can see I got one here, and this one in particular, I got a Bradley Beal Green out of there, Evan Fournier, and Trevor Ariza. Well, on the last one, and you guys haven't seen this yet, but I had just joined one of the Chase My Cards. He does those chases for Prism cards. And I just completely whiffed. That video hasn't come out and probably won't be for a while. But in the same day, I actually got delivered a hot one of the breaks that I was in. And I didn't have any cards at all. But I got this pack because I had the Houston Rockets. And I opened it up, and I swear to you, I got this Zion Williamson, which is probably like a $200 card, I'm guessing, raw, but it looks really good. It's a little off-center, I think, from left to right, as you can see here, but everything else looks pretty good. The off-centering isn't like crazy. I'd say it's like 60-40, so it might be like a 9.5 or something like that, but the back looks really good. It looks really clean. It's got sharp corners. But this is, I could be wrong, but this could be my first Zion that I've ever pulled. I don't remember pulling another one. I don't know if you guys have seen me pull one in any of my other videos. Maybe I have. I don't remember, though. So, at least this is definitely my first Prism, because I haven't opened any Prism. This was the first Prism pack I opened. My first Prism pack was a Zion, so that was at least some good news. Something cool that happened. I thought I wanted to share that because this is my first one, and I'm just stoked. It was a Zion, and obviously this card's worth quite a bit in a 10, and it looks really good. I should send this in to get graded and see if, you know, I get a 9 or a 10. I think a 9 is the same price as a raw, but a 10 is worth obviously more. I think like 800 maybe, I don't know. Anyways, just wanted to share that news with you guys. You guys let me know, what would you do about that card? Should I ask for a refund? Or just, you know, maybe resell it as it is, because it's not, you know, centered well. Yeah, I don't know. We'll see. We'll see what to do. And also that I'll probably send out an update about me shipping all of these. These haven't even gone into your guys' packs yet. These are just some extra cards on top of what I've made. But anyways, I just had a lot of fun with that. I just wanted to share that. I want to share that little bit of news. I'll probably upload this. I've actually got another mail day that I filmed and I haven't uploaded yet either. So I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care. Thanks for watching.